This is 5 on your side at 6, focused on you.
Tonight, a man in St. Charles County is charged with murder following a shooting in Wentzville, and a neighbor is getting credit for helping put an end to a 6-hour manhunt. Thanks for joining us. I'm Mike Bush.
And I'm Ann Allred. Just over an hour ago, the prosecutor's office shared the name of the victim, Leon Anderson from St. Louis. 5 on your side's Megan Kernan reports from Wentzville, where it happened.
There's someone running around who I just heard murder someone.
Kimberly Moore lives in the neighborhood behind Hidden Valley Drive and heard the entire argument from her back porch. It was around 10:30 Tuesday night when she suddenly heard a woman yell, "What are you doing?" multiple times.
It's a scream I've never heard before. You could tell from the way that she screamed that something really awful had just happened.
The woman told police she was in the bedroom with Carlos Hood, who she started dating about a week ago. That's when she says her on and off boyfriend of 3 years, Leon Anderson, showed up and broke in through a bedroom window.
I heard a male voice say, "Get out of here."
After a few minutes of arguing, the woman says Hood grabbed a gun, shot Anderson, and ran off into the woods. The victim ran out of the apartment after being shot and collapsed near the parking lot. That's when the woman called 911.
We sat around until about 3 to 4 in the morning with helicopters out, megaphones, yelling for whoever it was to come out with their hands up.
After about 6 hours of searching, officers caught Hood with the help of a neighbor's Ring camera. Sergeant Jacob Schmidt says they're praising the resident who came forward.
They knew we were looking for somebody in the area working this investigation. The detectives went over and reviewed that and identified our suspect, confirmed that that was our suspect. So then we closed in the perimeter on that area, and thankfully we were able to take him into custody safely.
Hood is facing charges of first-degree murder, armed criminal action, and unlawful use of a weapon, and is being held without bond. The woman said the victim didn't threaten Hood or herself during the argument and was looking to get to the bottom of the relationship.
A florist and daycare owner has been arrested for the death of a baby in her care. Prosecutors say the 4-month-old boy died in February. The medical examiner says he suffocated due to the way he was positioned. Judy Fields is charged with endangering the welfare of a child, resulting in death. Investigators say Fields was caring for 16 children by herself and was operating the daycare illegally without a state license.
Congresswoman Cori Bush claims that she delivered $2 billion to St. Louis, and this week we verified that claim. Now she's releasing a revised list of numbers. Our political editor, Mark Maxwell, is here with what he's learned. Mark.
And the first billboards went up a month ago claiming Cori Bush delivered $2 billion to St. Louis. That's a staggering number, one so big we've never seen it before from any politician. So we started asking to see the numbers behind it. It's part of her broader messaging push to show that she's steering our federal tax dollars back to St. Louis. But after our story first revealed several errors in how they added up federal grants and other funds, some of those signs started coming down. We asked the campaign if they'd taken them down, but they didn't respond. Then, this morning, Bush doubled down with that Instagram post and with altered numbers, drastically different than the initial billboard. The Congresswoman's office added $16 million under the Inflation Reduction Act, subtracted $500 million in federal grants, shaved off $17 million in disaster relief and $200,000 in transportation funds. But that big column there, an extra $362 million in extra ARPA funds. Just last month, Bush herself appeared to draw a distinction between money that was headed here, with or without her, and funds she actually delivered.
People assume that some of these funds just automatically come because you are a congressional district. They do not. We have to fight for some of these dollars, for a lot of these dollars, for millions of these dollars. We have to actually fight. And for our office, it's been tens of millions of dollars that we fought for that was not just given to our district.
This whole messaging push is Bush's attempt to counter criticism that she voted against other projects in President Biden's popular infrastructure bill. But that big $2 billion claim needs a lot of context. That $1.5 billion in ARPA money that makes up the bulk of it, that was coming to St. Louis with or without her input. And aside from voting yes, the whole stimulus package that went out to the entire country had very little to do with her.
Right now, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is updating neighbors in North St. Louis County about their ongoing efforts to remove radioactive waste connected to the first atomic bomb. Our Justina Cornell joins us live from the Florissant Municipal Court, where that meeting is happening. Justina.
Well, tonight is their annual meeting, and we've seen multiple people show up here for this open house. Now, just a few hours ago, we actually took a tour with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to take a look at their current projects. crews continue to clean up along Coldwater Creek. As the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers remediates radioactive waste.
We've gone from 11.5 million in 2014 up to 40.7 million in fiscal year 24. So due to that increased funding, we have increased the capacity.
That's enabled them to remove waste underneath the McDonald Bridge in North St. Louis County. It's one of the projects they'll discuss in their annual meeting Wednesday night.
I've been trying to come to every single meeting the Army Corps has hosted, particularly since the closure of Jana Elementary.
Former Jana PTA President Ashley Burnham hasn't missed a meeting since.
I think it's important for folks like the Army Corps of Engineers to align real people with the samples that they're pulling away from the creek and the radioactive waste. The two cannot be separated.
Last year, Jana Elementary shut down and it remained shut after conflicting reports that radioactive contamination made its way onto school property. Now, recently, the agency removed more than two Olympic-sized pools of radioactive waste along the banks of the creek near the school.
The other goal coming out of this, right, is transparency and communication. I'll engage with anybody that wants to engage. I think collectively, we're all stronger to move forward, and so that's what our team's trying to do.
Now, this meeting is a snippet of a bigger picture involving this contamination. Representative Tricia Burns is one of many local advocates fighting for change.
The biggest message is to make sure that Missourians that are harmed know that Missouri representatives and elected officials are behind them.
Local advocacy group Just Moms STL is in Washington, D.C., campaigning for compensation for victims as well.
It's really important for the government to take responsibility for the waste it left behind. Just because it's justice delayed and denied does not mean it's not justice overdue.
Now, right behind me here, Representative Tricia Burns is actually hosting a news conference right now outside of this open house. And coming up at 10, we'll hear more about her calls for change. Reporting live, Justina Cornell, 5 on your side.
Let's take a live look outside over Busch Stadium. The Cardinals will face the Pirates in about 40 minutes. Little toasty out there, 90 degrees. Meteorologist Jim Castillo has the weather first forecast.
Yes, you know, the high today, 91. And so the good thing is the sun's going down for tonight's game and temperatures 89 now. It will be going into the 80s, so pretty comfortable. Tomorrow for the day game, we're not really used to this heat yet. So you have to get acclimated to this heat. Temperatures tomorrow expected to be in the low 90s during the game, but the feels like temperature near 100 at the height of the game. All right, so take it easy out there. 89 right now and that humidity level 39%, but the dew point did climb, so it was a little steamy today. And then right now the feels like temperature, Creve Coeur 90, St. Charles 91. And again, these numbers are something we haven't seen in a while. So 70 degrees again tonight, so we're not going to really get that low outside of the city in the 60s, but there's already a heat advisory from Kansas City to Wichita tomorrow from 1 to 8 p.m. And then we're watching these storms to the north. We'll tell you how close they'll get to us tomorrow night and that chance of severe weather in just a few minutes.
You can get the weather first forecast anytime online. You just text the word weather to 314-425-5355. We'll make it easy for you and send you the link.
Coming up, mercury causing mail delays in town and country, the accident that shut down the post office.
It is the 5-year anniversary of one of the greatest nights in St. Louis sports and perhaps one of the greatest speeches in St. Louis sports history. We'll hear from a 2019 Stanley Cup champion later in sports.